Men only have four moods.
$101 for a Krabby Patty? With cheese, Mr. Squidward.
With cheese.
Eating our axolotl was eating black worms. Copper, 10 tenths.
And
looks like noodles.
It rains, and it's from heaven.
Melanoid, 8 tenths.
Don't you know each
missed a few. Cute
heaven.
Face, though.
You'll find
albino leucistic, 2 tenths. Missed them all, but
Michelle
still cute. Golden albino, 12 tenths. Love the effort.
Aquascaping our axolotl's new 85-gallon tank. First, we placed down rocks, sand, and PVC pipes for caves. Then, we built up rock formations around the pipes, including this really cool arch. Next, we siphoned over the water from the axolotl's old tank. Then we moved sock, followed by cheese, over to their new home. And then lastly, once the girls were all settled in, we just had to finish filling the tank. Here's how the finished aquarium looks. I'm super happy with the way it turned out, and I think the girls are loving their larger space.
All right, here you go. Here is your baby axolotl update. This is the clutch that was laid in late April and hatched in early May, and to be entirely honest, I am not sure why they are so small. They get fed twice daily with twice daily water changes, which is the same thing I do for every single clutch, but overall, this clutch has just not been doing well. In fact, out of the 644 eggs that were laid, only about 55 have survived to this stage. At this point, they're over a month old and they should be twice this size. And for those who keep asking, here are the twins. They are doing great. They are doing fantastic. They are eating and growing. And look at that full belly. And they got legs. Well, I mean, most of them have legs, but this one was just posed so nicely. With all of that being said, this is the second clutch that my oldest axolotl toothless has fathered where the survival rate just hasn't been that great. So I think it's time to retire toothless. So I guess this is also an announcement to say this will be the last clutch of eggs that toothless fathers. But it will not be the last clutch of eggs here at Stress in a Box Aquatics. I'm going to be breeding again soon, so keep an eye out.
So if anybody was curious on how I know when it is time to feed my eyeless axolotls.
They assume the position of waiting for food to fall from the sky.
And for those of you who are new here, when I say eyeless, I mean they literally don't have eyes. They don't. This is Toph, and this is Blinken.
But yes, this is their way of sending a subliminal message that it is time for feeding. So, I guess I should go get them food.
I've never tested to see how long it would take them to revolt.
Also, my banana plant made a new leaf.
It's such a happy banana plant.
Who wants to go ahead and pack an order with me? So today I actually have a pretty large order going to North Carolina. Like 12 by 12 by 12 box is large for me. So first we're gonna go ahead and give them a big ass ice pack. Once we got that shoved in there, now we're gonna pack the axolotls. So this person got this big, beautiful female from us. This is Honey. She was a surrender that came in. And she'll be the first to go in the box. Next we got Kinky and Janky. We'll go ahead and we will add some more paper to this box. Some Seachem samples. Marvy, I need this. Thank you. All packages come with styrofoam to go ahead and keep the cool inside the box, especially here in the summer months. Slapped our label on here and they are ready to go to their new home in North Carolina.
OMG, my axolotl laid eggs. Hundreds of eggs everywhere. They are starting to form. OMG, OMG. Oh, look, triplets. Look at our first hatchers. Now we have hundreds of baby axolotls. So cute.
I told myself for my own sanity we were not going to talk about my lightning bug axolotls anymore, but here we are. I purposely kept them out of the spotlight because another content creator took my videos and was spreading a lot of misinformation about them, and I just didn't want to deal with it. But we're here to set the record straight today. Lightning bug and firefly axolotls are made by swapping the tails of two axolotls while they are still in their eggs. As these pictures show, you can clearly see that they are hardly developed. They don't even have a nervous system at this point, therefore they feel absolutely no pain. And after they hatch and they grow, they develop and they are completely fine. This is a physical alteration to the animal, therefore it does not affect their genetic code at all. One of the biggest pieces of misinformation out there is that they have a low success rate, and people assume this because they are so rare to find. But in fact, the reason they are so hard to come by is because there's only two breeders in the entire world that make these guys. In fact, the breeder that I get mine from says that they have a 100% success rate. Side note, I do not recommend holding your axolotl like this. I just wanted to show you how shiny Pineapple's tail was. Sorry, Pineapple, I love you. While I know lightning bugs aren't everybody's cup of tea, I personally think they're super cool. This whole process was actually originally created to see if they could take transplanted limbs. Do you guys have any additional questions? Leave them in the comments down below.
Hey, can we go on land?
No.
Why?
The sun is a deadly laser.
Oh, okay.